I'm Sir Tap Tap, and welcome to Let's Play Super Galaxy Squadron EX, which apparently has a story that I haven't bothered to read before. So you can just read that. While the relations spread peacefully, Alpha Anti-Centetti, sentiment humans, killing many species. It disappears a bit hard for soon for me to actually read this. But this apparently comes with the original Super Galaxy Squadron Classic. It's a launch option in Steam. I haven't played the original, but this looked right up my alley. It's a pixel shoot 'em up with different chips. It looks really cool. You can read the story if you want. I usually complain about text being too slow, but this is too fast for me to read. But I mean, it's a shoot 'em up. There's bad guys. You shoot 'em. You go up. That's all there is to it. It's got endless and arcade modes. We're just gonna... wait. I guess I need to delete my save. I did a little bit of a... six stages. Screen shake. One thing I must say, the game controls great with the controller, and there was absolutely no fuss in getting it to work, which is honestly a rarity lately. This is not the first level, so how do I... can I not reset the game? I did a practice level. I want to... I can just... I'm very tempted to go casual, but I'm just gonna go veteran and play normal. I'm not gonna beat this game. Let's just give you a quick look at how all of these ships shoot. This is one of the things that made me very interested. There's a whole bunch of different, like, I'm a big supper for, a big sucker for shoot 'em ups with lots of different weapon types. Like, that was all in Star Soldier and all that. My favorite thing was seeing the fully upgraded versions of every weapon. I really like the sword guy, like the second dude there. So we've got a variety of twists on standard shoot 'em up things. Like, this is a pretty straightforward one. This is the not quite Raiden toothpaste laser. Like, I don't think it homes, but pretty wacky. Just lots of forward missiles. So I guess we can be SETI or human. Is he a defector or something? Yeah, he's a defector. Cool. I like the laser, but that sound effect may get annoying. Oh, I love the rotating things, but I gotta go with the sword. Oh, of course he's Japanese.
This is the NRV, Yoshida of the Geon Security Outfit. A massive SETI fleet just warped into our system and opened fire. We're outgunned 30-1 here.
Bye-bye.
All Federation vessels, this is Control broadcasting from Federation HQ. That was a distress beacon we just received from Sinsari. As of 2 minutes ago, we've lost contact with the last of Geon's security forces.
We may not
know the full situation, but HQ is ready to consider this an act of war. We're deploying all available ships to stop this before they do any more damage. We've also been given clearance to launch the Super Galaxy Squadron, so back them up with all you've got, and this should be over in no time. Good luck out there. Control out.
Here we got story. Good old Centauri. I don't remember them being quite this rude in Babylon 5, but there's a different... Hyper is not the ultimate. What is the... how do I do the secondary? Or do I just not have it yet? Oh, no, I don't have it yet. You can see in the top right there, there's power-ups for both primary and secondary fire. I love cave-style shoot-em-ups, like bullet hell games and stuff, but one thing they just don't have very often is fun, changeable weapons and power-ups and stuff. You know, it's all about the dodging, not so much the shooting. That's the secret of bullet hell games. That, like, it's kind of funny to call them even shoot-em-ups or shooting games, because, I mean, they're dodging games. There you go! That secondary. I love it. But yeah, the feeling of upgrading your ship and stuff, and like not like like RPG element upgrading, but just, you know, getting power-ups that make your gun shoot more gun. That's the sort of thing that I miss that more modern bullet hell games don't really have. Speaking of bullet hell, I'm not really sure what my hitbox is here. I assume it's that dot on my ship. I'm not sure if it's the whole ship. It could be. The bullet patterns are a little dense, so and there was the word bullet hell in there, so I kind of assume. Yeah, I think a bullet went through though, that bit of my sprite. I prefer when games just explicitly show your hitbox somewhere. Ah, damn it, I took a hit. There, you have a health bar in this, obviously. I keep hiding, but I can't hide. That was my hyper there. It helped less than I thought it would. I'm forgetting that I have a melee range weapon here. Though I guess my normal shots are now getting a decent range. Oh, I lost my secondary! Ah, I'm not good at this yet. Yeah, I've been trying to force myself to play. I have a whole bunch of really cool shoot-em-ups that I want to show off, and I've been letting myself get all, you know, get performance anxiety, and I want to show them off well. But I don't really have time to play a whole ton of them and, you know, get good at each of them. I just want to show them off decently, you know, give a quick look, and I mean, I'm not absolutely horrible. Like, my base skill is probably higher than most people's in shoot-em-ups, say the least. I mean, most people are pretty bad, frankly. But, we bleed combo. I've never been a huge fan of the constantly depleting combo meter thing, but I guess that's how this game does score. But I mean, I'm never a big high score hunter. I just want to beat the game on one credit is usually my highest goal that I ever achieve, or, you know, beat all the modes or whatever. I don't... Score is a bit abstract for me as a goal. Lava just shoves a big ol' sword in him, my hyper. Yeah, this has gotta be a tiny hitbox game, because I mean, I should be getting hit if it weren't. Oh cool, it erases bullets too. I mean, it should, but, ah. Not all games, ow, do what it should, ow. Maybe I should have done casual. I should have been a filthy casual. I'm sorry. I'm the filthiest casual right now. It's dying, though. So am I, but, I'm not sure if... I think since I'm on, like, non-hardcore mode, my health restores between levels or something, probably? I forget exactly what it said. If the enemy has a health bar, I can't see it. I don't think it does. I'll pay attention next enemy boss, if I survive to it. I'm not sure if this lets you credit feed or not. Like I said.
Super Galaxy Squadron, the SETI are retreating from Sinsari. Great work. HQ has decided to go on the offensive to end this quickly. We have intelligence on a mining operation in Indy. It looks like it's one of the biggest suppliers to Tau SETI, so we're sending you in there to put a stop to it however you can. It should be lightly defended, but don't let your guard down. Control L.
Okay, this game's already out on Steam. I kind of missed the boat on catching it for launch. A review copy of this was provided by the developer. I forgot if I mentioned that. I always try to make sure I disclose that. It doesn't really affect my opinion in my, like, personal estimation, but it's important to disclose stuff and keep it all above board. We've got some bullets that we can erase. It's cool that... I'm not sure if all shots do that or just my sword swipe. I'm sure this guy is way better the more you're... Like, it seems like you really need the power-ups for this ship, or else, you know, you can't reach very far, and it's just increasingly dangerous the lower your power is. Yeah, I want that secondary way up. I want to see maximum secondary. And yeah, it looks like our health did refill between levels, so that's good. So I was kind of taking a beating at the end there. And this does have an easier mode, I'll remind you of that. So if this looks like too much, you can do it easier. There's some ships that are... This is probably one of the more advanced ships, I would guess. Because, you know, it's basically melee range. There's other ships that, you know, spread fire everywhere or, you know, at least have long range. And there's some homing missile stuff. You can choose whatever your playstyle supports. That's something I really like. That's probably my favorite feature about this game. It also looks great, which helps. Oh, by the way, I don't want you to think negatively of the game because of this, but this is a Game Maker game. You can make Game Maker games 60 frames per second. It's literally a config file, or like a setting change. Like, you type 60 instead of 30 in one spot. I don't know why, like, maybe there are some developers that don't know that, but generally speaking, no. If a Game Maker game is 60 or 30 frames per second, it's because the developer either wanted it to be that way or didn't think it mattered. I don't tend to agree that it doesn't matter regardless of what game it is, but yeah, you can be 60 frames per second in Game Maker. And Game Maker can make game, you know, there's no performance issues in this game. 10 Second Ninja is also another very twitchy, good 60 frames per second game that was made in Game Maker, and you'd never know it from looking at it or anything. Like, Game Maker is not a bad engine, it's just cheap and used poorly because, you know, it's cheap and it's easy to use. Also, Game Maker recently has had a bug where Alt F4 isn't mapped right. Like, Alt F4 is disabled, basically. It's a bug. They're gonna fix it. One thing that's very noticeable in the game industry right now, I feel like I'm talking about Hyperdimension Neptunia whenever I say that, but anytime Unity or Game Maker have a bug, it's very noticeable because, like, every indie release for a month will have the exact same bug. Recently, Unity had this bug. Oh, there's a health bar at the top. Yeah, in shoot 'em ups, you want to generally have the health bar actually at the bottom, or I've seen games just put them on both. Oh god. Dying. Because, yeah, I can't look up. I'm sorry. So, yeah, it would make more sense to have it either at the bottom or both. I think Mushihime-sama does it at both.
This is control to all Federation vessels. The attack on Indy was successful, but they saw it coming. We have SETI forces advancing on Barnard as we speak. Super Galaxy Squadron and all ships stationed in Centauri, make your way there. It's a foothold on the core systems, so we need to make sure it stays in our hands. All ships in Seoul, you're going to hit the SETI head on in the Kyle to draw their attention. Control out.
I'm not sure how long I'm going to survive here. If I get a game over... Oh, wait. I can change... Oh, cool! Alright, who... Do I want to be? Who's got homing missiles? Oh, it's an AI? Cool. I love these little profiles. Like, it obviously doesn't matter, but I love when games have stuff like that. Oh, he had very little armor. So who's got tons of... I really like her gun. I like that too. There's so many good ships! That was like an enemy ship sort of attacks. Who got the homing missiles? Are these homing or not? I can't tell. Dragon clone. We all have different hypers too. I think that's something that's really underrated in games like this. Is I think I'm gonna go with Big Laser Guy. It's like the opposite of the sword. Ugh. That's so crunchy. I actually really like that. It's not pixel by pixel smooth. That's pretty cool. And these home! Ugh, that's really cool. This is seriously the opposite of the ship I was just using, so that's perfect. I really like this a lot. I don't know if I'll, like, how many videos I might do on it. Like, I was just planning to do one, quite honestly, and, like, go until I got a game over. But I'm really liking this. What I was thinking is I would do streams of shoot-em-ups in addition to, like, doing this. Like, you know, my normal quick look style Let's Plays. Because, like, odds of me recording a good run in a Let's Play are pretty low without lots of practice, which I don't frankly have time for. I wish I did, but I don't. If you would want to see a bunch of streams of me doing, you know, shoot 'em up games like this, let me know in the comments. I'm hoping to do something like that. Why am I all powered up already? My other guy never got powered up this high. And frankly, this is less impressive powered up than the swords, like, because you really felt the difference with the swords. Like, it looked really good. And, you know, your sword is really fast and punchy. You know, this just looks the same. I do like my giant laser, but, I don't know. Sometimes it's not that flashy. Lasers are stable. I was thinking, I mean, I am a developer, but I'm not a game developer. I was sort of thinking if I'd ever did something, I would want to make a shoot-em-up that just has, like, every staple old-school, like, 16-bit shoot-em-up weapon, like, the green wavy things. You had to have the green wavy things. You had to have your standard boring machine gun that has the widespread, flamethrower, like, Star Soldier had most of those standard things, and, like, a bunch of other stuff, too, and you'd have to have the options, and, like, I don't know. I was also thinking, like, I would have a bunch of different warning screens for bosses, because, like, that's one of the cool things every series does, is it has to have its own really cool, you know, warning boss approaching. One of my favorite is Hidogata Happa. The boss warning thing is like, danger warning 666, and there's like 1,000 different warning signs pop up on screen, and then you hear a warning siren. It's so good. I would just want to do that all day and not actually program game. I would just want to make cool warning stuff. So this is definitely an easier ship to use. It's not super flashy, but I mean, it obviously works. Oh, I got a hit, finally. This game's fairly forgiving, though. You get some of your power back. Well, I guess you get all of it if you don't let it fall away. I love those lasers that you charge up with the tiny little beam, and then they release with a huge, like, sound effect and, like, super wide. That is the best kind of laser. If you make a video game with a laser, you gotta make them like that. I'm sorry, it's required. It's just not as cool otherwise. Like, this main laser I've got, pretty cool, but, like, if my hyper doesn't, you know, put a bead on him and then, like, unleash this huge one, I'm gonna be a little disappointed, I'll admit. Modified battle armor. Albatross. Okay. Okay, we don't put the bead on him, but it is that wider laser that I was figuring it would be. It's also very nice when the beam sort of widens. I mean, it's not really how physics work, but that's not important. What's important is making it look awesome. I can't believe I was such a wussy and, like, didn't want to, like, show me playing shoot-em-ups, because, I mean, this is great! Why was I not playing this before? Ugh. You turn into a robot? Come on, man, I can't do that. That's just rude. You can't just do that when I can't. This isn't Galaxy. Speaking of that game, I guess an upgraded version of the game released, Galaxy, and it doesn't have Chapter 5 yet still. I'm just very confused by what is going on with that game. Nice. I love that big laser. The big laser makes the slightly boring normal attack feel less lame. Like, it's worth it, I guess. I'm still gonna switch after this one, because this is kind of plain. It's obviously effective, but I want to show off a bunch of different stuff. I honestly expected to do worse. Maybe I should have done, well, no, I shouldn't have done hardcore. This is fine. I need to stop worrying about trying to look so good.
Have taken a hold of both fronts, and HQ wants to keep this momentum going as long as possible. Forces in the Kale and all other vessels in the area advance into YZ City. Forces in Barnet advance into UV City. Expect heavy resistance, but you have the Super Galaxy Squadron backing you up. Control out.
I would appreciate subtitles. Obviously, no one's gonna play for the story, but I mean, I really do appreciate subtitles. I always turn them on immediately. It's kind of disappointing when games don't have them on by default. Like, they never do, but I mean, I'm still a little disappointed. All right. Who had, yes, you, wait. Didn't you have, no, it was this. Yeah, I want to try her. I love the variety. It's so cool they have the captains, too. Like, it adds so much personality to it. Ah! Oh, that is so cool! She's got this is the laser I was talking about. You know, the tiny little laser that doesn't actually hurt, and then it turns into the big one. This is the kind of laser I wanted. I thought I knew I would like this game, but it's actually way cooler than I thought it was. And the ship design's really good too. Like, we got some really good pixel art going on here. Should probably turn up that music a bit. Actually, I think my music might just be down. But whatever. It's not a problem. Only bad mixing is a problem. Ah, crap. Actually, you can probably set, or could you? I did notice the settings options are a little. The settings options. But yeah, the settings are a little limited. That's pretty much my only complaint so far, really. But I mean, it works fine with my controller. It went full screen with no problem. It's more than, you know, I've had a lot of issues just getting those two things to work lately, so. I'm a little more lenient on your settings options. I said it again. Now I'm gonna say settings options every time I mean just settings. I can forgive your settings a little bit if the game just works. Because I mean, that's kind of the trade-off of a console, is you get less options, but it just works, and you don't need to worry about those options as much. But obviously I do prefer when there are nice juicy options. But at present, I just wanted to play a game and have fun. And that's what happened, so I can't complain too much. I was worried the sound effects would be annoying, but somehow they're just subdued and regular enough that I just kind of forget the big laser sounds are even there. Though I do have to say, the upgrades feel less impactful on this one, just like the last one. Like, they don't feel as impactful as they did with the sword thing. Like, that felt really... It felt like a really big deal every time I got an upgrade with that. I'm not sure why I'm not feeling that with these other ships. Unless... Do I start with full power? Maybe that's the thing? Like, I didn't start with full power on the first stage and I do on all these others? I haven't actually noticed. I just... busy shooting things and not getting hit. Kind of the main point, I suppose. I mentioned a bit ago, I don't tend to like the constantly depleting combo meter, because I just don't like that whole, hey, you have to not kill things and, like, you know, leave things on screen longer than necessary and stuff. Like, I tend to not enjoy that as a... Damn it. As a, Dang it. As a, you know, primary score gimmick. It also means we completely lose our combo once we get to the boss. Aw, man. Is this gonna be what I think it is? Yes, it is! Aw, man. I love these where you blow the bits off of the enemy ship and it attacks less because, you know, you broke bits of it. It's just so satisfying. I'm gonna do this. I didn't really catch what that hyper did, to be quite honest. It seems to have... Actually, I don't know if I would call it effective, because he hasn't taken much damage. I guess we have to defeat all of his bits. Damn it. Doing really poorly here. Ah, we died! Is that it? Oh. It kicked back to here. How many ships do I have? I don't rightly know. I'm sorry. Wait, don't drop health when I'm at full health? No, stop that! I can't use it. Drop it later. How could you do this to me? Why is everything dropping health now? Is this some sort of you sucked in the last fight, so I'm gonna have mercy on you thing? Oh crap, that was a bad idea. Oh, it's just like a huge detonation thing, I guess, is my hyper? I don't know. It doesn't have as good of a feel as the others. Oof. My mind isn't fully in its bullet hell mindset with this game, so I'm having a little trouble dodging this big wave. Ow. I shouldn't be. It's not too bad. Ah, but it's gonna kill me. Ah! It did kill me. I want to kill these back row things first. So the boss isn't even like real until you defeat enough of its defenses and it starts firing that bullet hell wave. So yeah. It kind of makes the blowing the bits off of the ship feel way less impactful, though, so it's kind of... That's a new one. I'm not sure I like that decision, because I like blowing the bits off the ship and, you know, progressively defeating it. It feels less cool when I... Damn it. So hypers do not erase bullets? I thought my... I guess maybe it depends on which hyper it is. I could have sworn my first one, the hyper in that sword ship, did. I guess this one doesn't. Okay, I guess it doesn't always do that laser, or that, you know, spinny one. I'll take that.